Today's class is about head injuries. This is the most common cause of morbidity and mortality in accidents. You know, in our country, mostly people die because of two-wheeler and major road traffic accidents. So, today we are going to talk about the most dangerous injury in accident, head injuries. So, the common major trauma. There are Western standard far more higher in our country. The extreme or high risk people are younger males because they are rash and adventure seeking and they don't wear helmet always. And elderly and infants are more prone to develop complications because of their biological behavior to head injury. Why head injury causes more morbidity and mortality? Because time is an important factor in managing the brain damage and spinal cord damage. So time is very critical. Because even slightest difference in the intracranial pressure causes significant damage in the neuron, which may be sometimes irreversible and the patient develops permanent damage. And these are all the common mechanisms behind head injuries. Motor vehicle collisions, assault, fall, gunshot wound, stabbing and explosion. But in our country, the most thing common thing is motor vehicle collisions. Now we go from external to internal of head injury. The outside scalp injury. You know, the scalp contains five layers: pneumonic, skin, cutaneous, aponeurosis, loose area tissue, and pericardium. The injuries may be a contusion without any skin, external discontinuity, collection of blood beneath the skin or inside the scalp tissue, or maybe an edema, which is called contusions or ecchymosis. The breach in the scalp. External part, skin, it may be a 3-dimensional laceration, it could be an abrasion 2-dimensional, or it could be like a complete avulsion, like a deep-rooted injury. The important problem with the scalp injury is bleed, you know, the head and having high vascular supply.